So I decided to hire a writer.
Yeah, and that's where I come in, and I interviewed 2 dog breed owners per dog, and then did some other little research and put together whimsical paragraphs, informational, hopefully, but whimsical paragraphs about each dog breed, and we published the book like that about a year ago.
Yes, and if you don't have your copy yet, you can get it at khkartnola.com, the website, or you can get it on Amazon as the Kindle.
Right, and we are out here on location today, so we are trying to speak loudly so that you can hear us. We're not trying to scream at you, but we do have some background noise. And we have 2 extremely magnificent guests today, and I do believe we actually have a winner.
And you have a winner.
Go ahead, Catherine, tell them about the winner.
Becky, you have won this week. Becky from Jefferson. For those of you who don't know, Becky was nice enough to bring us her dachshund guest a couple weeks ago. So thank you, Becky, and you will be getting a prize in the mail.
And Becky correctly guessed a Doberman Pinscher, and that is what our breed of the week is today. So get ready, guys. You are going to be treated to, to some magnificent creatures today. So I will actually stand here and read, just because we are having some background noise. And this is from the book about the Dobermans. My large, sleek, and muscular physique, covered with a glistening coat, can be an intimidating sight. However, I am not an aggressive or vicious animal. I can be an alert guard dog, but my discerning, obedient nature and extreme intelligence keep me grounded. Speaking of ground, I do need plenty of exercise. I am wonderfully loyal, affectionate, and clingy with my family. I just ask that you return that same love and adoration. And so that is our paragraph on the Doberman, and I think now we are actually going to cut to our live guests because they've been practicing, and just give us a second to turn the cameras around, and we're going to see some magnificent animals. And he's the male, and he is about 3.5 years old. He got a little distracted, so we
made somebody just arrived.
So we're going to try that again. But that is Caleb, and he is a male Doberman, about 3.5 years old. So let's see if we can get Caleb's attention.
So what they're doing right now is obedience. So these dogs compete in obedience, where they have to do certain behaviors at certain times.
Treats every time she comes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's totally.
He was treats.
That's enough. Get close. Let's do signals. How about that?
Sure.
Okay. Down. Good boy. Hey, sit. Good boy.
we lost Caleb, but we have another one.
We do.
Gracie's a baby.
And this is Gracie, and she is almost 2 years old.
Yes.
So we're going to try Gracie now.
She also loves Gracie. Get close.
Before we started, because we wanted to meet the dogs, because they are very much guard dogs. That's what they're trained to be. That's what they're bred to be. So we were asking her, like, the 3 top things about Dobermans, and she said, you know, to let people know that they are bred to be very guard dogs and alert. They also are very loyal and affectionate, and some people don't think that they would be, but they are. And that they also are very obedient. However, getting their attention is sometimes difficult because they are bred to alert. So, and I think that's exactly what happened here. We had an unexpected guest, and she came in, and they're alert, and they just totally went off task and went to see the guest. But that's okay. So here's our coloring page for the week, the Doberman, and it will be on the post for you to download. And we had two coloring pages today. This was Audrey, age 11, who did a Doberman for us. Nice job, Audrey. And then this is Sandy, who didn't want to give her age, but she said she did a Doberman that was getting a little older, so she graded a little bit. So that's Sandy's Doberman. And these, I mean, you can just see how magnificent these Dobermans are.
They're running around crazy.
We're gonna see if Karen can work with them and do a couple of commands, maybe. But their attention might be lost.
Do you want to try one more thing?
Based on that, obviously that's not it. But you might want your dog to go get something for you.
Right.
Healing is that they can stay under control and walk next to a physician in obedience. Between the front of the head and the shoulder needs to be equal, even with your left hip, no matter whether you're turning, running, walking, or whatever.
And so basically, you send them through these commands, and you compete against each other all the time.
Well, there's really not time on that. But you go in with 200 and they take points off from the
Okay.
Even to the
and
zero.
All dogs take points. Right. You know. Okay.
So Bryce is just learning, but she's a pretty obedient little girl. I don't know if she heals the grass because I'm wrong. We'll try. Okay, sit. Are you ready? Let's go. Very cute, so definitely tune in and we'll be back at our regular day and time now.
don't have the book, remember, you can get it.